guide for crafting in Red Dead Online. How to craft, where to buy pamphlets, and the most important, which pamphlets are good and which are just a waste of money. To craft, you have to use a campfire, either at your camp or one of these public campfires. You can find one in Valentine, in Saint Denis, and in many other places. From the very beginning, you know how to craft food and most of the basic tonics and some other stuff. But there are locked recipes that you can unlock only by purchasing pamphlets. Small life hack, you can go to the item selection wheel and choose this option. That's how you can craft ammo, bites and horse food, for example, at any place you want. But you're not gonna be able to craft tonics or food. To buy pamphlets, you have to go to the fence. Fence are marked on the map with a special sign, and you can find many of these places, for example in Saint Denis, Rhodes, Thief's Landing or at Emerald Ranch. Sometimes pamphlets can be found in a treasure chest or looted from NPCs, but drop rate is pretty low, so you're probably gonna have to buy. After buying, don't forget to read the pamphlet. At fence you also can buy melee weapons, baked beans or moonshine, but in this video we're gonna focus on pamphlets. Keep in mind that this week there is a 25% discount for all the pamphlets, but I'm gonna show you the price without the discount on the screen. But to be honest, you have to buy the good pamphlets for any price, even without the discount, and the bad ones I'm not suggesting you to buy, even if it's gonna be 70% discount instead of 25%. And the first example of this pamphlet that I'm not suggesting you to buy even with some big discounts is a tracking arrow. Special arrow that helps you to track down the bounties. But I don't think it's really useful. First, it's kinda hard to craft. It's hard to find the ingredients. Second, you can do this bounty missions really well even without this tracking arrow, and to use it you have to use a bow as one of your weapons, and that's not the most effective weapon in PvE, to be honest. It costs 600 without the discount, and that's a lot for something that you're not gonna use too often. The only use for this arrow in PvP is to shoot griefers with it and make them stink. It's not really effective, but it's gonna humiliate them a lot. Express explosive pamphlet, and that's something you definitely have to buy. It costs $1,000 without the discount, but it's a great tool for PvP. Damage from this ammo is insane. In most situations, one shot is gonna be equal to one kill, and the most important, you can carry 40 pieces of this explosive ammo with you. 10 for rifles, 10 for repeaters, 10 for pistols and 10 for revolvers. It's crafted using animal fat, and you can get this from many animals. Pigs, ducks and even bears. But I don't suggest you to hunt bears, because you know what, I have a bear too and I've lost it. I don't know where is it, and if you're occasionally gonna shoot him, you're gonna show some real disrespect for me, and that's not gonna be good. So you better think twice before shooting bears. Next one is a horse ointment pamphlet, and just like any other pamphlet that has a horse in a description, is not something you wanna buy. You're not gonna ever struggle that your horse doesn't have enough stamina if you have good saddle. And fortifying health bar, even using level 3 health tonic, is not gonna protect your horse from, let's say, griefers. From my tests, these tonics are not as powerful as tonics for humans. As you can see, you can buy any pamphlet using gold, by the way. Incendiary buckshot pamphlet goes next, and basically that's a fire ammo for shotguns. It's not as effective as explosive ammo from my tests, but there is one huge advantage. It's crafted using moonshine, and you can buy moonshine. You don't have to run across the map and find these animals to grind some animal fat. You just can go and buy some amount of moonshine and craft this pretty powerful ammo. The price is high, so I recommend you to buy this pamphlet only if you have a lot of money, because it's not something that you must have, but it's definitely gonna help you to fight griefers on a higher levels. Explosive slug goes next, but I would rather buy an explosive slot. It's gonna be much more effective. Just imagine, griefer goes and sees this slot, he comes closer and boom. Here we go. Anyway, explosive slug is an explosive ammo for shotguns and shotguns only, so I don't really recommend you to buy it. You can carry only 10 of these bullets, and it's also crafted from animal fat, so if you have one, you would rather craft regular explosive ammo. Also keep in mind that this pamphlet is really not cheap, so I recommend you to buy it only if you have a lot of money and you already have most of the other pamphlets. Small game arrow. It's an arrow that can help you to not ruin the carcass quality of small game, of these small animals like squirrels, and that's the only way to get this perfect carcass from them. But small game doesn't cost too much, so you're not gonna make too much money from it. And also keep in mind that you have to spend some time and also money crafting this arrow, so it's not gonna be all that profitable. So I believe that buying this pamphlet for $350 is not that much of a great investment, unless you are role-playing person with a bow and you like to play with a bow only. Special horse medicine. Again, I don't recommend you this pamphlet, because you're just gonna be fine with a regular horse medicine. No need to make this fortified health status. Special horse reviver. It's just like regular reviver, but also it fortifies the health status for your horse. Again, I don't recommend you to buy this one. I'm pretty sure that you're gonna be absolutely fine without this pamphlet. Special bitters. Restores stamina and fortifies to level 3. It's not something you gonna need too much, because you can buy this level 2 tonic for stamina and you will be just fine with it. Special snake oil, just pretty much same as the previous, but for a dead eye. And again, you don't really need this. You're gonna be fine with level 1 or level 2 tonics for a dead eye that you can buy or craft. Split point ammo. In theory, it should increase your accuracy, damage, and reduce the rate of dead eye use. And from my tests, it actually increases damage just to the level of high velocity ammo on the mid range, for example. But I'm not sure whether it increases the accuracy. I couldn't prove it. And it seems like it doesn't affect the rate of dead eye usage at all. So I didn't found this split point ammo really useful at the moment. But on the other hand, it costs not too much, and with this discount, you maybe should buy it, because someday they will fix it and it's gonna be a good choice. Also, it has some benefit. It's super easy to craft. You only need to have a knife and a bullet. Horse meal for $400. And at first I thought that it's a meal made of horse, but it's not. It's food that you can craft for your horse if you for some reason love it too much. And in my opinion, it's pretty useless. It's gonna fortify the statuses of your horse, but who cares? I remind you, you have infinite stamina on practice, and fortifying health status not gonna help you pretty much ever. Dynamite arrow. This one is good. It costs a lot, but you absolutely have to buy it, especially with this discount. Dynamite arrows are easily crafted. You can get all the ingredients really easy, but they are extremely powerful, especially in PvP. Oh, mostly in PvP. It's the best way to counter this godlike like of God mode tank build, where people are eating a lot of tonics, have slow and steady, and fool me once and they just refuse to die. But with the dynamite arrow you can one shot kill them and make this from a really, really long range, because you can mark targets with painted black from big distances. Next one is a fire arrow, and this one is not something that I would recommend you to buy, because first of all, pamphlet is pretty expensive. Second, these arrows are crafted with use of animal fat, and as you already know, there are better ways of using this resource. And also, these arrows are not as powerful as you might think, because they are not dealing that good with the tonics. So I can recommend this pamphlet only to people who like to watch how animals or enemies burn. It's beautiful. Fire bottle, you just throw in around these bottles and they burn. Again, it's not that much of an effective weapon in any situations, but it's pretty cool. Also, you can use painted black and always hit your target, but still this weapon is not so effective, so I'm not sure whether I can recommend you this pamphlet. Poison arrow is just not too good. You can't use it in PvP. In PvE, you can use it to hunt this largest animals, but it takes ages while they die and you have to wait, so it's not worth it in my opinion. Poison knife, it's like a poison arrow but a throwing knife. Again, you will be super fine without this weapon, and I can recommend you to buy this only for roleplay reasons. Two bites go next, and at some point I decided to make a video about the bites, but I found that they are not really good, because you have to spend a lot of money to place it, to craft it, and you're not gonna get that much profit from it. Even if you're abusing some cougar spawns, for example, even then you're not gonna make a ton of money. You'd rather go get some collector's items. It's gonna be much more profitable. So it's not something that I recommend you to buy unless you are role playing some hunter. And as you can see, the only reason to buy many pamphlets is roleplay and roleplay only. Special horse stimulant. And I guess you know the rule now. If it's horse in a title, we just don't buy it, especially for this amount of money. Next one is absolutely must have. Special health cure. I've been testing this level 3 health tonic in many of my videos and it's absolutely imbalanced. You can eat a lot of damage using this one. This level 3 tonic is so much better than level 2 tonic for health that you can buy anyway. It can eat so much more damage, and yes, you have to craft it, but you can easily buy all the ingredients from Madame Nazar, so one tonic will cost you $6, and just look what this tonic is capable of. I've made this godlike tank build that is almost immortal. It can be effectively countered only by dynamite arrow, and it's just too strong. This build is the main reason why many people are refusing to go PvP at the moment, so you absolutely have to buy this pamphlet. Special tonic fortifies all your bars to level 2, and to be honest, I'm not sure whether you need it, because all you need to be fortified is a health bar and you need to fortify it to level 3. Also, this one is kinda hard to craft. You're gonna need 6 pieces of 3 different herbs, so you're gonna waste a lot of time, and I'm not sure whether you need to do it. Last two pamphlets are for improved dynamite and fire bottle. They are called dangerous in Russian, but they are not really so dangerous from my tests. They increase the radius from which dynamite would hit your targets, but teal dynamite is not that effective in a real PvP, so I'm not sure whether you need to spend that much of money for these pamphlets. Again, unless you are role playing some sort of dynamite psycho who tries to make this big bada boom. And one more tip for crafting this game. If you like the craft system and you wanna craft tonics and ammo, you have to level up the trader role, because that's how you will be able to carry more of ingredients with you. That was my opinion on all the pamphlets, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you agree with me or disagree, please let me know in the comment section. And as always, thank you for watching. See ya. Goodbye.